Hello friends, today we will start with INS. INS acronym is International Nuclear Information System. So you can see the website of the INS. This is the website of the INS. Okay. So INS is established in 1970, located at Vienna, Australia. The International Nuclear Information System, INS, hosts one of the world's largest collection of published information on the peaceful uses of nuclear science and technology. INS covers all aspects of the peaceful uses of nuclear science and technology, from nuclear reactors, reactor safety and nuclear fusions to applications of radiations and isotopes in the medicine, agriculture or industry. Many of the other related topics like environmental, legal and social aspects associated with nuclear energy, as well as economic and environmental aspects of non-nuclear energy sources, are also covered. So basically it covers nuclear as well as the non-nuclear energy sources. So INS is operated by IAEA, its acronym is International Atomic Energy Agency, in the collaboration with the 127 member states and 24 cooperating international organizations. All the content it holds is currently available free to all the internet users around the world. One word comes as fiber. Fiber is a PC-based input preparation package specially designed for the purpose of INS. Fiber stands for Friendly Inputting of Bibliographic Records. Okay, INS Atom Index is published by the INS. IAEA stands for International Atomic Energy Agency, established in 1957, located at Vienna. INS is operated by or sponsored by IAEA. So in the paper it can be written as operated by or sponsored by, so you should know about it. BARC full form is Baba Atomic Research Center, located at Mumbai, established on 3rd January 1954. BARC is the input center of INS in India. INS collaborated with BARC in India. So basically, what are the functions of INS? INS possessed most of the world's scientific and technical literature that falls within its subject scope. So there are basically the four functions: bibliographic databases, information reference services, full text and annotated web documents. So what is bibliographic databases? So bibliographic databases are basically the databases which has the list of books. So it basically currently has 3.3 million bibliographic references. Okay, so these 3.3 million bibliographic references are being published in the INS website. So you should know everything about INS. Other than that, information reference services, it has different information reference services as well. Basically, the reference services for literature on the peaceful application of nuclear science and technology. It has full text as well. At present, 3 lakh full text publications are there. Annotated web documents or web directories, as directories. You may know the directories. I told you before what are directories, right? So it has a growing database. It has a database where there are the annotated links to the different websites on the internet that are related to various fields of nuclear science and technology and IAEA work. Okay, INS also maintains a unique collection of full text non-conventional grey literature that would be difficult to obtain elsewhere. So you should know what is grey literature. Grey literature is a literature either unpublished or has published in non-commercial form. Okay, like examples of grey literatures are government reports, policy statements, and issues papers. So there are the different questions which are being asked in the previous past UGC paper. Library and Information Services Division of BARC is the national center for. So BARC is a national center for, as we have discussed about it, it is a national center for all INS activities in India. Next comes, INS is an example of, it is basically an example of centralized input and distributed output. Centralized input and distributed output. Which is the following network does not have its own telecommunication infrastructure? So if you are like, if you can see the options, there are in different options there is written net. Wherever there is net written, basically these are networks, different networks. So as you know that NIC net is actually introduced by NIC. NIC, which was established in 1976 under the Planning Commission by the Indian government. Okay. Other one is the ERNET. So ERNET is Educational and Research Network. Educational and Research Network. So it is controlled by the Ministry of IT. Government of India, its headquarters is in New Delhi. What other option is Euronet? Euronet is basically a worldwide, a global provider of electronic payment services. It is basically is in Euronet. Euronet is in Europe. It has an American headquarter, worldwide provider of electronic payment services. So its headquarters is in Leawood, Kansas. Okay, so the only option remain is INS, because it is saying does not have its own telecommunication infrastructure. Thank you. Like, subscribe, and share. And we will come in the next class. Thanks.